In the distance education, just as the teacher has its own role and responsibilities, similarly, the learner has also one's own responsibilities. In distance learning, the student and the teacher, they are geographically separated from each other. In most of the cases, the learner is in isolation. Maybe there are thousands of learners enrolled for a particular program, but the learner, one learner may not be knowing that the second learner or some other learners are located in the nearby area. So ultimately what happens is the learner lands up studying or learning in isolation. So in this journey of learning, for that learner, he or she is alone. One needs a lot of motivation in order to keep learning in this isolation. The motivation is needed for studying, for keeping working, for maybe reading the coursework or working on the assignments or the different types of the material that has been given by the university. The learner, since is in isolation, needs to be independent in terms of the study habits. If the person is having the kind of study habits where one is more and more dependent on others, such person may not be so much successful while studying through distance mode. So one should be able to understand the content independently and then take the study at a further level. Since the learner is located at various geographical locations and may be in isolation, one needs to be active in terms of learning. Of course, there is a counselor or there is a teacher involved who motivates this learner, but the learner should be able to actively take steps of its own learning even in the absence of this counselor or the teacher. So one needs to be a active learner than a passive learner. The learner therefore needs to have the self-study habits, because it is the responsibility of the learner to understand the content, and the counselor comes into picture only when there are difficulties faced by the learner. But even for asking those difficulties, the learner has to basically make some attempts to understand the learning material that has been given. Only then the counselor's help will be of use for this learner. The learning opportunity that is provided by the distance mode makes sense for the learner only when one is able to link the theory, the principles or the general rules spoken about in the study material, and link all these things with the world of work or actual the working in the institution. Unless they both of them are linked with each other, the theoretical knowledge remains only as a part of theory in the books, and the skills they do not get inscribed into the learner as a learning process in the distance education. In order to have the successful learning experience, the learner has more responsibility in the teaching learning process when it comes to distance mode. The responsibility of the learners here is much more than the responsibility in the conventional mode. When we say that the distance mode offers lot of opportunities for the learners or for any person who wants to learn, who wants to get educated, these opportunities are offered to the learners through something called as the student support system. Now this students or the learners, they are coming into the world of education maybe after a long gap. So they need this support from many areas, and many levels of support is needed. So when we see an open university, it is there is a headquarter situated at one place, and the students are spreaded over a wider geographical area. The institution which is located at one place cannot take care of the minor needs of the learners who are enrolled. That is why they need something called as the regional centers. So the university headquarter may be situated at one location, whereas the regional centers are located at the various regions of the operation of that particular university. For example, if we take an talk about IGNU, Indira Gandhi National Open University, it being a national open university, the regional centers are located in every state. There is one regional center. If we take an example of Yashwantrao Chavan Maharashtra Open University, which is a state open university, the regional centers are located at places like Mumbai, Pune, Nasik, Aurangabad, Nanded, Kolhapur, Nagpur. Thus, the regional center takes care of the working in that particular region. After the regional center, there comes the third level, that is the study center. Now, study center is the actual place where the learner goes for the face-to-face contact sessions. Thus, the support system that is made available for the learners is through three-tier system. That is, one is at the headquarters, then the regional centers and the study centers. Success of any open university depends largely on the quality of the student support system. Student support system provides the window for the learners to the university. Through this system, the learner peeps in into the university and maybe as a beginner just see what is available for him to study, then choose the appropriate course of study, and then follow it up through the studies later. All this process is done for the students through this student support system. We shall now see the how this system works at each of these three tiers. The first one is the headquarter level, that is where the place where exactly the open university is located. The main responsibility of the student support system at the headquarters begins right from making the learning material available to the students. So the university, open university, provides the common learning material prepared for a particular program. The quality is ensured in that. Also, the uniformity across the various study material is ensured by the open university headquarters. Once the material is printed, then the next task is the reaching out this material to the learners. Now, there are different types of modalities possible over here. The first one is sending this material to the regional centers, from regional centers to the study centers, and the study centers then call all the students enrolled at that study center and distribute the study material. The second modality, where the headquarters sends the material directly to the study centers and they distribute to the learners. In the third modality, the material directly goes from the headquarters to the students enrolled directly. At times, it is possible that the study material is ready and it is made available through online mode or through the website of that particular university. Another responsibility of the headquarters is the provision of the adequate manpower as well as infrastructural resources at regional centers and also provide the guidelines for the same for the study center. Depending on the need of a particular program, the manpower is decided at the study center. But these directives are designed and developed at the headquarter. For example, suppose there is only counseling session involved as a part of the contact sessions, then maybe one counselor for every 40-50 learners enrolled is sufficient. But if there is a coursework like research programs, then maybe one counselor can take care of maximum 5 to 7 learners' researches. So there is it is prescribed in the guideline that for every 5 learners there will be one counselor or one guide will be appointed for those 5 to 7 persons. So depending on the course content and the need of the course, this kind of manpower is prescribed by the headquarter. It is not only prescribed, but it is also ensured by the headquarter that this kind of infrastructural facilities as well as the manpower is actually available at the study centers. The headquarter takes up the institutional visits before allotting the study centers with the required manpower and infrastructure. Even after allotting the status of a study center to a particular institution, the headquarter persons, they take the visits to the study center intermittently and ensure that the coursework is being conducted over there as per the specifications given. Another major responsibility of the headquarter is the training of the human resources at the regional center as well as at the study center. Now this kind of training comes into picture for two aspects. First one is the academic aspect. Suppose there is a new program launch, then how to exactly conduct this particular program through contact sessions, all the guidelines are given by the headquarter. The counselors at the study centers or the instructors at the study centers, at times even evaluators, guides, they are trained by the personnel at the headquarter. This is especially from the point of view of performing the academic responsibilities at the study center. Another type of responsibility comes is the in the form of the administrative role. So suppose there is a software developed for online admission, then the personnel at the study center, they need to be clear about what is their exact role in this admission, exactly how will the software run, and what are the documents to be checked, and so on and so forth. So the administrative personnel from the study center, they are trained by the headquarter for performing these responsibilities at the study center. So whenever there are any systemic changes or whenever there are any changes in the course content or evaluation strategies, the personnel from the study center, they are trained for the purpose by the headquarter. The headquarter takes up such kind of trainings as and when the need arises. The headquarter also coordinates the activities at the regional center as well as at the study center. Now, as a program schedule is concerned, there are different kinds of activities during different phases of the year. Maybe at certain times the institutions are applying to be a study center. Maybe there is a phase where there are admissions going on at the study center, whereas at the tailpiece there would be the exams being conducted at the study centers. So the headquarter personnel has to keep track of exactly what is expected to happen at the study center as well as at the regional centers, and then act accordingly. they have to sometimes be proactive in terms of the requirements that will get cropped up at the study center as well as at the regional centers. When we come to the headquarter, there are many smaller divisions and sections working in the headquarter itself. So the person who is looking after a program has to ensure that there is the coordination amongst all these various sections so that the good quality of learner support or the student support is given to the students. It is ensured that the timeline that is followed for a particular program is scrupulously followed by every section that is related to running that particular program. The program has been developed by the university, but there needs to be takers for the program as well. So the dissemination of the information of the program with the larger society is another major responsibility that the headquarter personnel has to take up. So they give the advertisements, maybe at times they write the articles. At certain times they also go to various places and conduct sessions or talk to people face-to-face mode. Maybe at times this dissemination of information could be through website or even some facility like YouTube and so on. So the whatever efforts are taken by the Open University should be made use of by the larger society, and the university takes every care to make such efforts. Thus, there are so many roles that are performed by the headquarters when it comes to offering the good quality student support services to the students. We shall now see which are the internal sections of the headquarters that are directly linked with offering the good quality of student support services. The first and the foremost is the schools and divisions. Just like in any conventional university, the terminology department is used. Similarly, in case of open distance learning, the terminology school is used. For example, school of education, school of computer science, school of architecture, and so on. These schools and divisions, they have the basic and the major responsibility of developing a program which will be of great use for the learners and for the society. So the person who is looking after the program from that particular school is called as the program coordinator. The program coordinator looks into every detailed aspect of program development and also of the program operation, that is the actual offering the program to the learners through the various student support services. So they design a program in such a manner that is useful for the learners, and they are also responsible for developing the system for offering the programs. What would be the coursework that is expected, what is the manpower at the study center to handle this coursework, how will it be evaluated, and so on and so forth. All these aspects are dealt by the school in an open university. The student services division is one of the most crucial division in any open university. Just as the school handles the academic responsibility of any program, the student services division takes care of the administrative or operational responsibilities of offering a program. The student services division has two smaller sections. Number one is the section related to the regional centers. The headquarter being the governing body for all the regional centers, this student services division has a section which gives the directives to the regional centers as well as keeps collecting data from the regional centers. The second section in the student services division is the registration section. Now this is the section where the actual enrollment of the students take place. The students are enrolled maybe at times through online mode or at times but through hard copy forms. The students are registered over there. The prospectus is once again their responsibility, and the applications that are gathered, they are scrutinized in terms of the minimum qualifications acquired. Then the data, they are given something called as the permanent registration number, that is PRN, to the learners. It is the registration section which passes on this data to the other sections of the university. This is the first place in the university where the student or the learner, they are given their own identity, and then this identity is retained through all the other sections of the headquarter. Once the data from the registration is fixed, once the number of enrolled students, their names and other key information is fixed, that data is given firstly to the store. Now store is that place in an open university headquarter where all the learning material, especially in the form of the printed material, gets collected, and it is stored at this place. Depending on the enrollment, district wise or regional center wise, this study material is disseminated from the headquarter to the various places. The store has to ensure that the study material goes to the in the respective either regional centers or study centers, or at times directly to the students. If the students make any mistakes in writing their contact details, then the persons at the store, they have really tough timing reaching out the this material to the appropriate learners. So it is it's like a big warehouse, and the system of working over there is in a way simple, but at times it becomes complex when there are more choices given to the learners in terms of the optional courses that they can offer. Another important section from the headquarter is the exam section. Now, as the with the more advancement of technology, the exam section has also started more and more working through the technological mode, or more on through online mode. This exam section has the important responsibility of creating the question bank, setting up the question papers, getting them printed through the confidential printers, having these question papers and answer sheets delivered at the exam centers, and then again once again gathering the all the answer sheets at the headquarter, and then assessing and declaring the results. So their responsibility ends only at the when the degrees and diplomas are awarded at the time of convocation. Since the this section is not something a unique feature when we compare it with the conventional university, but the uniqueness or the vastness in the their work definitely comes from the fact that there are lakhs of students enrolled in the open university. As compared to conventional universities, there are many types of programs, and therefore many number of programs offered by the open university. So one can imagine the kind of examination needed for so many varied types of programs. So the scope of the work of the exam section is very vast. And another challenge is all this work has to be done in a very confidential manner. So the whole system is established over there to look after all the nitty-gritties related to the exams. At times it happens that a student is enrolled for a particular program, at A center but would like to appear for the exam from B center, then in that case the exam section also has to keep track of allotting the same exam center to the students. Otherwise there is a lot of chaos at the study centers, and it creates a lot of tensions for the students as well. Thus we have seen that there are certain centers, sections and divisions in the at the headquarter itself which looks after the logistics part of this whole teaching learning process through distance mode.